Hi there. Thanks for checking out my journey video series where I'm discussing the lessons and the challenges associated with building a business from scratch, in my case, a video blog and YouTube channel. In my last journey video, I talked about it. That one was actually a follow-on video discussing the idea of the book, The One Thing. And so in my last video, I talked about the challenges associated with trying to follow that framework and specifically identifying, you know, okay, what is my one thing? It's not always blatantly clear or obvious. And so being able to make sure that you're focusing your efforts on the single most high leverage, high value task on a day-to-day basis is obviously a good thing to do, but it's not as easy as it may sound. And so to kind of follow on that point today, I wanted to discuss the idea that so when you're spending time thinking about you know what is my highest leverage task, what is my most important thing, what is my one thing, it becomes blatantly obvious that if you want to get to your goal sooner rather than later, that there are a multitude of things that are important for you to do, and that can lead to overwhelm. You know, when you see, I think the example that I used in the last video was, you know, figuring out, actually, I don't remember what the example was, but like, say, for example, you know, you're trying to figure out how to, you know, grow traffic to your website, and you're researching, you know, search engine optimization. When you start digging into it, you know, there's a ton of books, ebooks, articles, online courses, and there's, you know, 100 different, you know, gurus out there who proclaim to have, you know, the one thing, the answer, if you will, of, you know, what you need to do to be able to get your sites and your videos and whatever you're producing to rank on Google. And so when you start digging into it, it can get to be overwhelming. So not only is it hard to pick, you know, what is the one thing that you should be doing, but, you know, which source do you even turn to, you know, get your best or most accurate or most trusted information? And it can get to be overwhelming. And so as I've discussed in one of my vlog post videos, which I've included the link to here, when you have more choice in a situation, the natural tendency for humans is to actually not make any choice. We get bound up in opportunity costs. We get afraid of making the wrong decision. And so we end up getting locked into analysis paralysis in wanting to make the right decision, that ultimately we don't make a decision at all. And then we just don't make any progress. So the reason I bring it up today is that what I've found is that, you know, one of the primary strategies that you can use to deal with that overwhelm and potentially, you know, analysis paralysis is to just, you know, realize that whatever decision that you make, it doesn't necessarily have to lock you into it for the long term. So, you know, say you've got, you know, for going back to the SEO example, say you've got, you know, 10 different courses or books and things that you're looking at and evaluating and trying to decide which one to use or to follow, blog posts, what have you, you know, just pick one and say, I'm gonna use this for a week or 2 days or whatever timeline you decide you want to follow, and I'm gonna go through it, and I'm gonna put these strategies into action, and I'm gonna see where it takes me, and, you know, see how well it works, or see what I learn from it, or whether I get value out of it, or whatever. But, you know, don't think of it in terms of, you know, I've gotta make the right choice because that's gonna, you know, affect my path for the next year. That's not the case. Just think, you know, okay, I'm gonna pick this one. I'm gonna give it everything I got for the next, you know, week, like I said, or whatever time frame you want to work with, and then I'll reevaluate at that time and see whether I think it was a good decision or whether I want to, you know, take a different path or a different approach. But that gets you into the mode of having a bias toward action versus a bias toward evaluation. And, you know, once you start doing that, you're at least making some progress on a regular basis, and it may not always be in the exact direction that you wanted to go or thought you wanted to go. You're still taking steps and you're making progress, and that alone helps to improve your motivation, and that will kind of feed the beast, if you will, and to continue that cycle of taking more action. And then as you go along, you will be learning more and you will be gaining ground on your goals as you go along. So it's a self-perpetuating cycle, which helps to get you there, you know, by hook or by crook, even though you may not feel like you're making the best choice in at every, you know, point in time. So just pick a path, you know, commit to it for a few days or, you know, what have you, and just, you know, start taking action. So very important to just pick a path and take action, and that's been working well for me, both into make progress on my goals, but also to, you know, kind of deal with the over information overload / overwhelm that is out there in the world today. So I've found that very helpful, and I thought I would share that with you today. So hope you like this video, and I'll see you next time.